stop right there.
Easy. Easy. You know I'm not with Trinity.
Why should we believe you?
I escaped with one of yours. A man named Jacob.
Where is he now?
We were together, but we got separated in the mines.
She killed him!
No! No, 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 no!
Jacob would never trust an outsider.
Please, listen, I am not your enemy.
I warned you. You should have left.
Sophia! Enough!
Father! I thought I lost you.
I'm glad you made it out of there. Go give Sophia, she is cautious.
In her position, I'd be the same way.
What did you find out?
Trinity is coming in force. We must prepare.
Her?
She's a friend. On my word, no harm will come to her.
These ruins. We must be near the Prophet's lost city.
Come. We do not have much time. Prepare the weapon stores. Secure the battlements. Go! Now! They're almost here. But we're outnumbered.
The children and elders are vulnerable.
Go. Get them into the catacombs. Light the fires. The valley must be alerted. Sophia, muster our fighters, then meet me in the upper village.
Don't disappear again, Father.
There's much to do. If we had more time...
Later. For now, I'll do what I can to help.
Vase must have been beautiful once, but someone's poked a few new holes in it and filled it with dirt. They must have used it to grow seedlings.
Let the other settlements know what's coming. I'll do what I can. You two, I need eyes out across the valley. Head to the cliffs and take watch. I want to know the moment you see their helicopters.
Yes, of course.
If we see anything, we'll sound the horns.
Go with God.
Greetings.
We must keep them away from the Acropolis Tower, no matter the cost. We'll send the families into the catacombs below. But we have to keep the enemy engaged here, on this side of the valley. Sophia and her warriors have already...
Jacob and his people are resilient. I'll give them that. Trinity is on their way. They could do with my help. And this atlas from the mural, if it really is some kind of map of the ruins, I've got to find it before Anna. If I don't, then all these deaths will have been in vain. And I can't have that on my conscience.
Thank you.
Greetings. War is coming. We have to prepare. Soviets left everything when we drove them out. Most of it is just waste, but there's still the odd treasure to be found. It's been a long time since Jacob brought an outsider here.
They need arrowheads for the battle. Then I need more firewood.
I've already cut plenty. Besides, I don't know how much more time I'll have left to forge.
We can make points faster than broadheads. That should be our focus.
Not much fuel left in the torch. I think I can get through it. Then we'll have to find more.
That's gonna be a problem. I was in prison a few summers back. After that, you're back to using a hammer and chisel.
Here's a crack.
We spent 2 full days combing the old building. That's the last. Don't worry. We'll light the chisel. Never run the fire.
I have never felt such terror. Tonight, the armies of the Mongol horde camp at the edge of the valley, ready to strike at the heart of Kitesh. We have the alchemist's fire at ready to set the invaders alight. Every man and woman who can wield a weapon will fight. We will do all we can to support the Athanatoi, but I have never seen bloodshed. None of us mere citizens have. I have never taken a life, and now that I must, I fear for my resolve.
Greetings.
You're Jacob's guest. If you're looking for a way to help, they're repairing the guard towers just down the path. I mean no offense, but you don't look like you're ready for a turn on the anvil. How's the cutting coming?
Slow. Gotta be careful. The rough leave weak spots. We should have kept the metal dry during the rains.
We had to use those sheets to patch the roof last year, when we had the floods. Make do with what you can. Jacob said you rescued him from the prison.
It was a joint effort.
Well, whatever you did, we're grateful. We won't turn away another pair of hands if you can help. But we're not accustomed to visitors.
Another difficult winter for my people. There are more deaths than births now. And as the seasons pass, the young ones are becoming restless. I see them looking to the sky when the rare plane passes overhead. Wistful. Wondering. Longing. I know they are still deeply committed to the cause. But I also sense a change coming. An end to our way of life is on the horizon. The most recent invaders are fading from memory. But as the technology of men advances, more are bound to find our valley again. And we are bound with the fate of this place. For better or worse.
Sorry, I've got no time to talk. Jacob says you can be trusted, and that's good enough for me.
I made a mistake today. One that threatens to lead to more mistakes. I spent time alone with Alia. Something I have avoided until now. She reminds me of my beloved Sophia, whom I thought I'd long forgotten, and it opens my heart like a wound. She clouds my judgment, even when she is not present. I sound like a giddy child, and those days are far behind me. I must bury these old feelings deep and stay apart from my people for a time.
If you want to help, you should head down to the lower village. I know you want to help, but I have to finish here. Armies need food as much as weapons.
I'll leave you to it then.
Hello there.
Oh, hell.
We know what to do here. We've been waiting for this. You're not with the invaders. What brought you to this valley?
I'm sorry I can't help you right now. I need to get this generator fixed so we can send a message to the other settlements.
I'll see if I can help elsewhere.
Please be careful here. This is the last of the old transmitters that will work, or used to work.
Thank you.
There was a flood during the storm. Knocked down some of the guard towers. Those things buzzing around the valley frightened many of the birds. But there are still gulls down by the water.
Or used to work.
It's not enough. We have to make do.
There has to be more. Send someone to go look.
You there. We could use some help if that's what you're here for.
I'm here to help. What can I do?
We're trying to fortify as many of these towers as we can. Most of them were badly damaged in last year's floods. We've got the repairs in hand, but I need some extra supplies from around the valley. If we can get these towers repaired, it'll give us an advantage over the invaders, and it'll help us reach the upper levels of the ruined towers. Will you help?
I'll see what I can round up.
Thank you. Bring them back to me when you found them.
There was a flood during the storm. Knocked down some of the guard towers. Those things buzzing around the valley frightened many of the birds. But there are still gulls down by the water. You want to earn our trust? Stay here and fight with us.
Prehistoric carving of the bear. The stone looks like it could have come from this valley.
Fires still rage in the outer districts. The last of the wooden buildings will be consumed by nightfall. The heart of our city is gone, buried beneath the ice. I can take some small solace in the fact that the Mongol invaders were killed, alongside the Prophet's warriors who died to save us. And the Prophet himself? No one has seen him since the morning after the siege ended. We need his wisdom. Now more than ever, we do not have enough food to feed those who survived. Some believe the worst is over, but I fear that is not the case.
Send who, exactly? Everyone's heading down to the lower village to prepare. I'm telling you, you have to improvise for now. What you're looking for?
Not yet, but I will.
Now I see. It speaks of something hidden. Young ones, you scoffed at learning your letters. Said it had nothing to do with hunting. But that's your first lesson. Everything is connected. And I am always right. You clever students who saw the folly and stubbornness and can read this, here's your first assignment. Track, hunt, and bring me back the pelt of one of the small creatures of the valley. Hares you can find anywhere, night or day. Both the little brown ones in our valley and the snow hares in the peaks. The squirrels stick to the trees, and rain will drive them into their burrows. And if you see fit to seek the rats, look inside the ruins, or anywhere the dead still lie. Please, do not bring me a rat. Followers of the Prophet fled to the east. The journey was difficult. Here is your lesson for today. Bring me any creature with feathers. The birds in our valley fly mostly by day, nesting away at dark. You've seen gulls and other kinds farther afield. Those common birds would count for today's lesson, but it would lack ambition. You clever students who wish to impress me would do well to head to the high elevations between dawn and dusk. I would find buzzard most impressive. And before you ask, the chickens around our village came here with our ancestors. Bringing me a tame bird from your mother's yard will not fulfill the assignment.
Rivka joined the Prophet because her husband, a Rus nobleman, was a believer. When he died on the journey north, she stayed with the Prophet, pondering what her place was amongst the believers. When she saw the valley, she knew she had found her purpose. She dreamed what Kitesh could be. She laid those dreams out to be built. It is because of Rivka that Kitesh became not just beautiful, but livable.
Rivka, the architect. There's got to be something down there. Astonishing. This architecture predates the rise of Eastern Orthodoxy. What were they doing here? Gold belt buckle. Decorative, but strong and functional. It appears to be part of a military uniform.
Left my wife in the care of these physicians. The sickness became exactly what we feared as her skin turned to scales and she lost all feeling in her extremities. They say there is nothing that can be done for her save for give her relief from the pain and ease her passing. But she must be kept far from the city, far from me. My wife will die, and I will never see her in this world again. I will hurry to the next to meet her. Thank you.
golden necklace of incredible detail. Whoever made it, it's the equal of anything found in the Empire. Looks to be a treatise on the connection between the body and the mind. We are crippled by our isolation. We have with us the combined medical knowledge of the Empire, a millennia of learning that tells us how to treat every ailment. But here, on the edge of the world, the lack of one simple flower leaves us helpless. I cannot do much for the afflicted. I know how, but I cannot because we have hidden ourselves away. These people and many more that follow will die needlessly, all to keep our secret hidden. I pray the prophet is right when he says that it will be worth it in the end.